Hi, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whatever may be the time you are seeing this video. The more I read pathology nowadays, I come across the term tumor microenvironments. And I'm not able to understand whatever given in the routine textbooks. They look very complex. So I started digging into it and have very good references. And I want to make it as simple as possible to you all. So use this as a stepping stone to go to the next level. And I'm making it ridiculously simple just to make sure you will get stimulated to read about it and go to the next level. And I am giving the handout also in the description, having a link in the description. Please download it and use it. If you have any comments or any interesting thoughts, to make it more simple, please let me know in the comment box. Thank you very much and have a great time. Tumor microenvironment is the buzzword now, and it's very essential to know about it for the prognosis and theranosis. Understanding of the tumor microenvironment is very important because two of the essential tumor nature, one is invasion, other one is metastasis, is widely influenced by microenvironment. So we have to know about it to explain why some tumors are behaving badly and why some tumors are having high incidence of metastasis. So the objectives of our presentations, introduction to the tumor microenvironment, and what are the components of tumor microenvironment. In each component, I want to discuss the source, the nature, and the mechanism of action. And last but not the least, is there any target for therapy on the mechanism of action? There are a lot of measuring and scoring system for tumor microenvironment. I will touch on it, but the main talk will be more on the components of tumor microenvironment. I will end it up with take-home message. I will give some references, and as in my previous video, I will give the references first, and then we will go with some pre-test and end it up with post-test at the end of the discussion. I want you all to do very well in the post-test because that will keep me happy as I'm able to improve your performance through this interaction. There are beautiful references available. I just noted four of them here. Tumor microenvironment at a glance from Journal of Clinical Sciences in 2012. Significance of tumor microenvironment scoring and immune biomarkers in patient stratification and cancer outcome. Another one in Frontiers in Oncology, the tumor microenvironment, a pitch for multiple players. And the last one is a tumor microenvironment and a differential response to therapy. I have given the links also, so you can type in these links and you can get the articles. So coming to the pre-test, these tests, there are 5 questions, single response questions, no negative marks. This is just to know what is your pre-discussion knowledge and compare it with the post-discussion knowledge after this video. Number one, targeted therapy is effective in mesenchymal type of TME, immunological type of TME, quasicellular type of TME, or all of the above. Question number two, myeloid-derived suppressor cells belongs to A, stromal cells, B, tumor-derived cells, C, inflammatory cells, and D, immunological cells. Number three, the nature of endothelial cells is pro-tumor, anti-tumor, both, or neither. Number four, natural killer cells cause tumor cell death by direct killing, inhibition of VEGF, suppression of CTL, stimulation of Treg cells. And number five, tumor antigen is presented to immune cells by T cells, B cells, dendritic cells, and adipocytes. Please note down these answers and let us compare it with the post-test after this discussion. So what is tumor microenvironment? These are all the tumor cells, and the environment around it is made up of cells as well as stroma. The stroma also includes blood vessels that are running through the tumor. There are three types of tumor microenvironment. As you see in this picture, you can all identify the tumor cells, but these tumor cells are outnumbered by the lymphoid cells in the background. So this is a type of environment called as immune or inflammatory type of tumor microenvironment. Why we have to know that? Because it is highly sensitive to immune therapy. Tumors showing a lot of lymphoid cells and other inflammatory cells in the microenvironment are highly sensitive for immunotherapy. The best example is malignant melanoma. The next type of microenvironment is known as mesenchymal type. Here, this is an best example of a desmoplastic small round blue cell tumor where you see a lot of desmoplastic stroma, but the inflammatory cells are very less in amount. The mesenchymal cells are more. That's why it is known as tumor microenvironment, mesenchymal type. Guess what? This type of TME is resistant to immune therapy. The third type of microenvironment is pachycellular type, neither mesenchymal rich or immune cell rich. Here, the tumor cells are predominantly made up of nests of epithelial cells with a clear cell border, cytoplasm with a distinct cell border. But the tumor microenvironment is pachycellular, and this is also very resistant to immune therapy. Now you might be able to understand why we have to type the tumor microenvironment, as the inflammatory or immunological type is the only type that responds to immune therapy. Coming to the components of tumor cells, there are predominantly four types: stromal cells, immunological cells, secretory components, and the tumor-derived cells. Each of them have their own members. In the stromal cells, we have five members: endothelial cells, pericytes, cancer-associated fibroblasts, adipocytes, and mesenchymal stem cells. In the immunological cells, we have T and B lymphocytes, natural killer cells, dendritic cells, monocytes and macrophages, and the myeloid-derived suppressor cells. Secretory components are made up of another five members: microRNAs, enzymes, matrix material, cytokines and chemokines, and the adhesion molecules. Tumor-derived cells are nothing but cancer stem cells that form the part of the tumor microenvironment. Before going into the exact nature of the components, we have to understand the tumor, as we told, is surrounded by some environment. Some of them are promoting the tumor to grow, to invade and metastasize. They are known as proactive tumor components. Others, they inhibit the tumor cell growth. They cause death of the tumor and disappearance of the tumor. These are known as anti-tumorigenic factors. So as you all logically know, to win the fight against tumor, we have to inhibit the promoters of the tumor, and we have to stimulate the anti-tumor activity so that the tumor can be successfully removed from the patient. Coming to the individual components, again, I am repeating, for each component, I will be stressing only four points: what is the source, what is the nature, what is the mechanism of action, and what is the target for therapy. And in the nature, is it a pro-tumor or anti-tumor? Endothelial cells are derived from blood vessels. They have pro-tumor activity, especially they decide what tumor cells can be allowed to metastasize. How do they do that? In any tumor environment, there will be hypoxia or angiogenic signal. This will cause vascular growth, which is abnormal. How it is abnormal? These neoangiogenic vessels are haphazardly arranged and they are very porous, and they have a very irregular blood flow. So what happens in the tumor microenvironment? These haphazard and porous blood vessels causes disproportionate blood flow, disproportionate oxygenation, and disproportionate drug availability. And thus, they act like pro-tumor agents. What is the target of therapy? It is available. The next one is pericytes. The source is from blood vessels. The nature is anti-tumor. In some papers, they mention low pericyte count is associated with poor prognosis and increased metastasis. Increased hypoxia with EMT, which is nothing but epithelial mesenchymal transformation and mesenchymal epithelial transformation receptor activation. They also prevent lymphocyte extravasation and activation. Target for therapy are available. For example, it is anti-AMG2 antibody. Cancer-associated fibroblasts, also known as CAF, they are mainly from the fibroblasts, but also derived from mesenchymal stem cells, endothelial cells, smooth muscle cells, and myoepithelial cells. They are having a character of pro-tumor. How do they cause pro-tumor effect? By inducing neoangiogenesis, which is FSR, by reducing the immune response to tumor, by promoting the proliferation of tumor cells by secreting various growth factors, and they also prevent chemotherapy agents reaching the malignant cells. It is also a target for therapy by giving MMP inhibitors, anti-TGF-beta inhibitors, and various anti-growth factors acting against cancer-associated fibroblasts. Coming to adipocytes that are derived from native adipocytes and they are pro-tumor in nature through secretion of adipokines, angiogenic factors, and chemokines like tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin-6, and CCL2. Adiponectin inhibitors, anti-CCL2, and anti-interleukin are available as therapy for this target. Mesenchymal stem cells are mainly derived from multipotent stem cells, pro-tumor in nature, by giving pericytes, adipocytes, fibroblasts, chondrocytes, osteocytes, angiogenesis by secreting VEGF, and modulating the immune response by secreting immune receptors. The target for therapy here is potential medication carriers through nanotechnology. Coming to T lymphocytes, as you all know, it's derived from bone marrow cells. There are three types of T cells. Cytotoxic T cells is having anti-tumor character, whereas T regulatory cells and the gamma delta T cells are having pro and anti-tumor effect. At this point, I want to mention some of the component can be pro-tumor, some of the component can be anti-tumor, and some of the components can be both pro and anti-tumor, depending upon the circumstances. The cytotoxic T lymphocytes, they are anti-tumor by killing the tumor cells directly. Whereas T regulatory cells have dual pro-tumor and anti-tumor effect as mentioned here. Pro-tumor by reducing the CTL, dendritic cell, natural killer cells and macrophages, and anti-tumor effect by reducing the immunity and reducing the tumor proliferation. Gamma delta T cells, they are anti-tumor through cytotoxic activity and interferon gamma production, and they are pro-tumor by reducing the CTL and natural killer cells and increasing the inappropriate or haphazardous angiogenesis. CAR, chimeric antigen receptor T cell therapy, is available as a target in this setup. Coming to B lymphocytes, again derived from bone marrow, they also have anti-tumor and pro-tumor. By producing antibody against tumor cells and cytokine secretions, they act as anti-tumor. But through the B regulatory cells that inhibit cytotoxic T cells and the natural killer cells in causing the tumor death, they act like pro-tumors. We can selectively clear regulatory cells as they are the pro-tumor cells and that can act like a target. Coming to monocyte macrophage system that is also derived from bone marrow, there are two types known in the tumor microenvironment, M1 and M2. M1 act like anti-tumor by activation of immune response, and M2 act like pro-tumor by increasing FSR angiogenesis and by reducing the CTL and increasing the T regulatory cell activity. The target for therapy is removal of M2 cells, as the M2 cells are bad guys here, and reprogramming of M2 cells to M1 cells to stimulate the anti-tumor activity. Natural killer cells are having anti-tumor activity. They are from the bone marrow and they cause direct killing of tumor cells through perforin and granzyme B. Recruitment and inhibition of migration of natural killer cells will help us in treating the tumor successfully. Dendritic cells are having both anti-tumor and pro-tumor activity. They are derived from the bone marrow. There are three types of dendritic cells at the tumor microenvironment: CD8 alpha positive plasmacytoid and the TIM3 positive dendritic cells. CD8 alpha positive dendritic cells have anti-tumor activity by tumor antigen presentation to CD8 T cells, leading to tumor cell death. Plasmacytoid is having anti-tumor activity by processing and presenting the soluble tumor antigens to B lymphocytes, whereas TIM3 dendritic cells have pro-tumor effect by suppression of HMGB1 dependent innate immunity. Dendritic cell cancer vaccines are in the development to act like a target in this area. Myeloid derived cells are derived from bone marrow. They are anti-tumor in nature. They suppress the CTL and the natural killer cells. They stimulate the Treg cells and they cause angiogenesis. Inhibitors of myeloid-derived suppressor cells can be used as a target for therapy in this setup. Extracellular matrix are pro-tumor and they are derived from native and the cancer-associated fibroblasts. They are the cells that select the clone of the tumor that can invade and metastasize. As you all know, invasion and metastasis, role of extracellular matrix is very, very important. They also create hypoxic and acidic microenvironment where the tumor cells can proliferate and survive better. They restrict the movements of immune anti-tumor cells and they prevent the medication in reaching the tumor cells. By reducing these selective extracellular matrix through the inhibitors, we can successfully treat by acting against the extracellular matrix. MicroRNAs are pro-tumor agents secreted by the cancer cells. Some of the microRNAs like 21 and 29A are secreted into the microenvironment. They are internalized by the adjacent immune cells. And this leads to alteration in their role by tilting to tumor proliferation. Deregulation of microRNAs expression can be used as a therapy in this target. It affects the tumor progression and the metastasis. So those are all the components. So please remember, there are four major headings under which there are 16 components, and we have to know nature, source, mechanism of action, and target for therapy for each component. So how do you measure and score the activities going on in the tumor microenvironment is the next point of interest. In this table, I am going to mention the technologies which helps to measure TME and what happens in immunologically unresponsive tumor and immunologically responsive tumor with these measurements. For example, the whole exome sequencing can be done, which shows high mutational burden in immunologically responsive tumors. There is increased activation signature by gene signature pattern. Epigenetic modification studies shows reduced Treg CD3 ratio and increased CD3 cells in immunologically responsive tumors. Protein microarray shows robust general antibody response. B and T cell receptor studies show high CD3 count and high clonality in immunologically responsive tumors. Increased number of effector cells and increased T effector and T reg ratio is identified by flow or mass cytometry in immunologically responsive tumor. And multicolor IHC shows increased effector cells or decreased suppressor cells with high PD-L1 on tumor and tumor infiltrating immune cells. So in a nutshell, the immunologically responsive tumor is more responsive to immune checkpoint therapies. So immune checkpoint blockade therapies and other immunotherapies can be first derived in immunologically responsive tumors, whereas vaccination, ablation, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, or oncolytic therapies and adaptive cellular therapy should be first tried in immunologically unresponsive tumors. What are the scoring systems available for tumor microenvironment activity? There are multiple scoring systems. I will just mention the names. Number one is Glasgow Microenvironment Score. Two, Microenvironment Cell Population Counter. Three, Tumor Microenvironment of Metastasis Score. Four, PD-L1/Tumor Infiltrating Lymphocyte Score. Cancer Transcriptomic Signature. And PD-L1 Tumor Proportion Score. These are all the scoring system available to measure the tumor microenvironment activity. As a human being, we are having a very subjective interpretation of this material. So who can help us in this area is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is our friend, and that is the future of pathology to help us in the fight against cancer. So all of you should start reading about artificial intelligence in the practical application of the artificial intelligence in pathology. So to conclude, as I mentioned, there are four main members of the tumor microenvironment: stromal cells, immunological cells, secretory components, and tumor-derived cells. And there are 16 subcomponents of tumor microenvironment. Tumor microenvironment itself is divided into three. This picture is a classic example of inflammatory or immunological tumor microenvironment. This is an example of mesenchymally rich tumor microenvironment. And this is an example of quasicellular tumor microenvironment. Why we have to know these three types? Because the top one is very sensitive for immune therapy, whereas the bottom two are resistant for immune therapy. So the bottom line here is there are a lot of promoters and inhibitors in tumor microenvironment. To win against cancer, we have to inhibit the promoters and we have to promote the inhibitors. I hope you understand this concept. I want to end it up with the African proverb, which tells, "Show me your friend and I will show you your character." But I want to create a tumor proverb where I want to tell, "Show me the tumor microenvironment and I will show you the tumor character." Thank you very much for listening to this discussion. Let us go to the post-test now. Answer it now and then compare it along with your pre-test answers. Targeted therapy is effective in, I will just give 5 seconds for you to read an answer. The answer is immunological type of TME. Question number two, myeloid derived suppressor cells belong to? The answer is immunological cells. Question number three, the nature of endothelial cells is it pro-tumor, anti-tumor, both or neither? endothelial cells or protube. Natural killer cells cause tumor cell death by, the answer is direct killing. And the last question, tumor antigen is presented to immune cells by, and the answer is dendritic cells. I hope you are able to grasp some basic things in tumor microenvironment. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comment area. I will get back to you. If you have any suggestions, please leave it in the comment area. And thank you very much. Stay positive and stay safe. Have a great time. Bye.